Hey, what's up Blender users, I'm Jonathan, and in today's video we'll go over the process of using photogrammetry for tech. And no, I'm not claiming that modeling now becomes unnecessary, but it is always nice to have an option like this one to just get real-world objects into 3D. I always wanted to be able to easily create sci-fi and tech props like Ian Hubert, without having to spend that much time taking hundreds of photos. This video is sponsored by Reality Capture, who provided me with the PGM license that allowed me to process up to 3500 images per project, which is perfect for the technique we'll use today. Oh, and by the way, if you enjoy my content, consider subscribing because I upload a new video every Saturday. And with that said, let's get started. Photogrammetry always was a pretty slow process, at least for me. This isn't caused by long processing times because, as you all probably know by now, Reality Capture is extremely fast. Now, it always took me way too long to take all the images, especially if I wanted the model to be well lit and textured. So I wanted to work on that next. What I settled on was taking a video of me just spinning the model on a wooden serving plate. This allowed me to finish getting the images in about 1 to 3 minutes. I also only had to light the model from the front. But now we have to somehow convert the video into images. So let me show you how to do this in Blender, because there are some things that need to be talked about. After that, we'll quickly finish up the model in Reality Capture and Blender. Before importing this video, let's quickly set up our workspace. Now, the easiest way to do this is to just click on this plus icon right here, go to Video Editing and choose Video Editing. This gives us our timeline, all the export functionalities, and even a file browser, which we don't really need, so let's close this window. You can now see that I have my video right here, which I will just drag into place. This video also has linked audio, which we don't need, so let's select the audio track and delete it with X. And you can also see that the whole sequence is 6,324 frames long, so let's just copy this over to the end frame. Now, this video was initially filmed in 4K, so let's multiply both the X and Y resolution by 2. If we would want to export the images in full HD, we could just export it at 50% of the resolution. This way we have the base resolution always set and we can vary it with the percentage slider. One thing to note is that if you have enough RAM, you can always just press F4, go to Preferences and under System give your video sequencer a higher memory cache limit. I've set mine to 8000, which is enough for me. Awesome, we can now just play the video and cut out the parts we don't need. Sadly, the video sequencer is still pretty laggy, so if I start dragging around the cursor, you can see that everything starts to lag around. So I will just try and find the timestamps where the plate starts spinning, which is right here. And now we can just press K to cut the video right here and X to delete this part. Now, if we try to move this video clip to the beginning, you can see that everything starts lagging again because we are still previewing everything. To fix this, we can change to frame 0, which always shows blank. And now we can just drag the video to the beginning without any lag. Right here, I stopped spinning the plate, so let's cut it again. And now to get a different angle to the camera, I had to switch the camera perspective, which also took some time, so I will have to cut out this part too. In this point in time, I started spinning again, so let's cut it again, delete the middle part, and let's switch back to frame 0 so we can move these videos together without any lag. By the way, you can also press and hold Shift to just slowly move the video clip. And now you would want to repeat this for as long as you have to do it. But for the sake of this video, I will stop right here and move on to the next step, which is to crop out the unneeded parts. You can see that right here the background changes color, but overall it stays static, which wouldn't really make sense for Reality Capture. So we have to crop out this part right here. The easiest way to do this is to use the crop function. We can just enable it and choose left and right values that fit our video. Let's for example try 300 pixels. And you can see that everything is cropped out correctly. But the camera has been stretched on the x-axis. The correct amount which we have to subtract is the sum of our cropping values. So let's subtract 600 and now everything looks correct again. But keep in mind that the crop value is only being applied to the selected clip. So if I for example select this one right here, we have to crop it again. So I would suggest you to just do it with the first clip and after that start cutting. If you don't want to do any color grading in Blender, we are now ready to export our video to images. But of course we don't need the whole 6000 frames. I for example want to export every 5th frame for this video. We do this by adjusting the frame step. The default value is 1, so it renders every single frame. 2 would mean every other frame, and 3 every third one. So we have to set it to 5. And now we are ready to just render our sequence. Even though Blender is pretty fast with video rendering, this still takes a few minutes. So I have already rendered out the frames. Of course, 1400 images aren't really needed, but I thought now that I can basically use unlimited input images, why not use a whole bunch? A quick tip on the side, if you think you have exported way too many images, you can always just select maybe half or a third of them by adjusting your folder view and just selecting this column. But for now, I will just select every single image and drag it into Reality Capture. And you can see that it has added all of the 1405 images. And now we can basically press start, but I always like to have some more control, so I will just start with aligning the images. And we can now see in the console that it has already detected all the features in the images and is now working on the matching process. With a dataset that large, this can take a few minutes, so I will cut the video right here. And just like this, Reality Capture has aligned all of our images. And I personally think this view has some kind of a beauty to itself. But now we can have a look at our bounding box and see that Reality Capture has guessed our model bounds correctly. If this was not the case, we can easily align it with the given tools and gizmos. And now everything that follows is the mesh reconstruction, the colorization and the texturization. So just press these three buttons in this order and you will be left with a model that looks like this. This right here is the final model I used for the thumbnail. You can see that I just used a third of the images, but these ones were exported at a 4K resolution. The dataset I used earlier in this video was only full HD. But you can see that this one worked as fine as the other one did. And so I was just able to press unmodel and export it as an OBJ file. Of course, you can choose any of the file types you like. I should maybe also quickly mention that you don't need a license to start working with Reality Capture. And once you want to export, you can use the pay per input function, which allows you to pay for the dataset you imported. Meaning you can use the same dataset as often as you like, because you just have to pay for it once. And this is actually pretty cheap. I never had a dataset that cost me more than 10 bucks. Of course, if you have thousands of images, I would suggest to visit their pricing page and see what works best for you. Okay, let's import the model into Blender and have a look at it. Even though this file is around 600 megabytes, Blender's OBJ importer can easily import it. And now that the model has imported, let's quickly fix its rotation by rotating it negative 90 degrees on the x-axis, and let's quickly apply the rotation. To make our work a little bit easier, let's add a decimate modifier and maybe collapse it with a ratio of 0.1. And now for the decimate modifier to take effect on our viewport performance, let's apply it with Ctrl and A while hovering over it with our mouse cursor. And now our viewport is nice and fast, and because of the decimate modifier preserves all the textures, our model looks as good as before. We can quickly select it, right click and choose Shade Smooth to make it even better looking. And you can see that our model doesn't really have any shadows baked in, as well as pretty good detail in the texture. You could of course now choose to retopologize your model and bake the texture on it. This way you still have to manually model your object, but you get the realistic textures for basically free. But this would break the scope of this video. So this is basically it. This is how we can use a video input in Reality Capture to create 3D tech models. If you want to start using Reality Capture right away, you can go into the video description where you will find a link to the download page. Thanks again to Reality Capture for sponsoring this video, and we will see us in the next video next Saturday.